December 9th, 1993, and shortly after 4 a.m., Galway Airport was at the center of one of the most dramatic air-sea rescues of the year. These Spanish sailors had been plucked to safety in terrifying circumstances, but in rescuing them, this helicopter team came close to disaster.
My most nerve-wracking moment occurred over 2 years ago when we had to go to the fishing vessel Dunboy, which was located 60 miles west of Slinehead. The boat had lost all engine power, so it was adrift in very high seas, high winds. We had to airlift 13 fishermen, and lifting the sixth man on board, our cable got snagged on the boat, snapped, and went up into our rotor blades, taking a few chunks out of a couple of the blades and doing damage to the rest of the aircraft. But we managed to limp back to Galway, where we were airborne again about an hour later in our standby aircraft.
Since 1991, when its new base was opened at Shannon, this rescue helicopter has flown over 600 missions. This weekend, it was back in Galway, and so too are some of the fishermen who owe their lives to the bravery of pilots like Carmel Lyons.
A winch malfunctioned on the trawler, and I completely crushed my knee. They brought me, they came, they called the rescue, the skipper of the boat called the rescue service. Helicopter came within 15 minutes and had me in the regional in Galway in another 15 minutes. Very fast, and very thankful to those people for what they've done.
If they hadn't been able to lift you off that night, how much additional pain would you have had to endure and suffering?
I would have probably lost a leg.
Would you recommend it as a career to other women?
I would recommend it to anybody, but especially the women who feel that they mightn't be able to do it, or that they feel they're breaking into a man's world. They can do it. If I can, anybody can.
But for John McDermott, the winchman left behind on the Dunboy, there was something of a fairy tale ending to that ordeal.
We turned into Galway, I could see my crew, particularly Carmel, who I thought I would never see again. And I couldn't wait to get over and give Carmel a peck in the cheek.
And he even presented me with the ring a short time later. We became engaged and actually hope to marry next summer, if all goes well.
I think perhaps the shock of the whole night would make you realise that life is quite short, and I didn't want to waste any time.
We're
here
going
we
to
are
make the
today.
Most of it.
Fox.